Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is it permissible to pray Eid prayers at home due to the masajid all being closed and the fact that we are in a lockdown due to the global pandemic? The answer to the question is yes, it is permissible. And the evidence for it is the narration recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah that tells us that Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, perhaps due to old age, if he used to miss the Eid prayer, he would gather his family and his sons and those working under him, and he would lead them in praying two units of prayer, two rak'at, saying the takbirat, like the prayer and the takbirat of the people of the city. Now, having mentioned the evidence, let's move on to a step-by-step guide in regards to how one should offer this prayer. Firstly, this prayer can be offered individually or collectively. And when we say collectively, it's important to highlight that, you know, if your part of the world is in a lockdown, it's important that you adhere to the guidelines set by your authorities, by your officials. So when we say collectively, we don't mean gathering all the neighbors together, because at the end of the day, social distancing is in place and we need to, you know, stay safe and help to mitigate the spread of the virus. So collectively, in the sense a family unit, father, mother and the children, they can pray together. Husband and wife, the two spouses, can pray together. Or, like we mentioned earlier, this prayer can be offered individually. And before I get into the steps, please bear in mind that as per the different schools of thought, we have different ways, different methodologies of offering the Eid prayer, and all of them have at the end of the day been deduced from the Sunnah, from the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, in a move to keep this video short and simple, I'm going to describe one version of it, and that version I feel is the most conventional and familiar version to where I come from. Now, this version, it is from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but again, bear in mind that by far it is not the only version that you are able to follow. Now, another important thing that you have to bear in mind, that in regards to the Eid prayer, there are ways for you to compound Sunnah actions. In other words, add Sunnah actions to this prayer and maximize your rewards. But by omitting one or two of them, they do not invalidate the prayer. The prayer is still valid, insha'Allah ta'ala. So like I said, to keep the video short and simple, I hope to list the essentials and a few Sunnah actions, maybe inshallah ta'ala. So to start off things, here are a few Eid related actions before Salatul Eid. Number one, supplicate unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the night before Eid and ask Him for forgiveness for any shortcomings, for any wrongdoings. And on the morning of Eid, recite the takbirat of Eid, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and rejoicing in the occasion of Eid. Take a shower, this is from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and celebrate by donning your best garments. It is also customary to apply perfume, to perfume yourselves. And you should go on to demonstrate the end of the month of fasting of Ramadan by eating something after Salatul Fajr on the morning of Eid. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would not leave his house on the day of Eid without eating some dates. We're not able to go out, but let us follow this Sunnah of having something in the morning. And let's congratulate others. Let's greet others. You can do so through messages, WhatsApp, send out emails, group video calls, congratulate your family, your relatives, your friends. You know, get into the spirit of Eid. Fulfill your obligation. It's actually an obligation of giving out your Zakatul Fitr before the prayer of Eid. The majority of the scholars are in agreement that Zakatul Fitr is mandatory for every believer, male or female, young or old, even upon the unborn child in the mother's womb in a family unit. So if you're living by yourself, then you just have to give Zakat out for yourself. But the head of a family, he has dependents under him, his spouse, his children, like I said, even the unborn child in the mother's womb, Zakatul Fitr needs to be given out by the head for each of these dependents, for the entire family unit, basically. Here in my country, in Sri Lanka, it has been calculated, the Zakatul Fitr amount has been calculated as approximately 500 Sri Lankan rupees, where 2.5 kilograms, approximately 2.5 kilograms of rice is given out for each individual, each member of the family unit. Now let's discuss the prayer step by step. You do not have to call out an adhan or an iqama to proclaim this salah. You will gather your family and you will offer it. You will lead the prayer, your family behind you. Number one, an-niyyah, the intention. Before starting the prayer, you will have to place the intention in regards to the prayer. Now, the place of the niyyah is the heart. So you will place the niyyah in your heart, where you will intend to pray Salatul Eid. The intention will not be for Salatul Duha or any other nafil prayer. No, Salatul Eid, you will intend that you are going to pray Salatul Eid. Step number two, Takbiratul Ihram. The first takbir. So you will tie your takbir. You will say Allahu Akbar. You will place your hands either on your stomach or your chest, whichever of the opinion that you follow. So you will raise your hands and you will tie the Takbiratul Ihram, Allahu Akbar. And after tying the Takbiratul Ihram, you will read Du'aul Istiftah. So for those of you who are familiar with Wajjahtu Wajhiya Lilladhi Fatara As-Samawati, you will read that Du'a. Or you can read Allahumma ba'id bayni wa bayna khatayaya kama ba'adta bayna al-mashriqi wal-maghrib wa naqini min khatayaya. That particular Du'a. Or for those of you who read Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika thana, you can read that. So whichever dua that you are familiar with, basically it depends on the school of thought that you follow, you will read the opening dua. It is known as the opening dua. And then after reading the opening dua, you will go on to tie an additional 7 takbirat. An additional 7 takbirat. So after tying the takbiratul ihram, you will read dua'ul istiftah, and then you will go on to tie an additional 7 takbirat. Now there are two ways in terms of tying the takbirat. One is where you raise your hands for each takbir. You will raise your hands for each takbir and you would tie 7 additional takbirat. And another school of thought opines that you do not have to raise your hands. You will leave your hands tied and go on to only articulate the takbir. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. As per the opinion of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, you raise your hands, and that is the opinion that we humbly sympathize with. So basically, after tying the takbiratul ihram, you read du'aul istiftah and then go on to say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You will go on to tie a 7 additional takbirat. After tying the 7 additional takbirat, you will start off by seeking refuge in Allah from shaitan, a'udhu billahi sami'il alim min ash-shaytanir rajim, quietly, and then you will read bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Again, as per the school of thought that you follow, you will either read it out aloud or read it in a hushed tone, and then go on to read Suratul Fatiha out aloud. This is the first unit. You will read Suratul Fatiha. Once you're done with Suratul Fatiha, it is from the sunnah to read another chapter after Suratul Fatiha. So as per one report from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is a sunnah to read Surat Qaf. According to another report, it is from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to read Suratul A'la, Sabbih isma rabbikal a'la alladhi khalaqa fasawwa. So you can choose to either read Surat Qaf or Surat Al-A'la. And let's say you are not familiar with these two chapters. Like we mentioned, it is from the sunnah actions. If you do it, you're rewarded. But otherwise, you can choose to read any other chapter from the Noble Quran, inshallah ta'ala, and your prayer will still be valid. So once you're done with reading the other chapter, you will go down now for ruku', Allahu Akbar, and you will go down for your ruku'. You will bow down. And then you will stand up, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدَ. And then you will go down for sujood. You will sit in between the sajda, and then the next sujood, and then now you will stand up for the second unit. Now as you come up for the second unit, that first takbir, the takbir of the qiyam, is independent. So you will stand up saying Allahu Akbar and you will tie your hands. Now you have nothing to read because du'aul istiftah is only for the first rak'ah. So after tying the takbir of qiyam, you will go on to tie an additional 5 takbirat. 5 takbirat. And once you have tied 5 additional takbirat, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, 5 takbirat, you will now read Suratul Fatiha. After reading Suratul Fatiha, you will read another chapter. So as per one report, it is from the sunnah to read Suratul Qamar, in the second unit. As per another report, it is from the Sunnah to read Suratul Ghashiyah in the second unit. So, you remember I gave you two reports in the first raka'ah as well. So if you go with Surat Qaf in the first raka'ah, then Suratul Qamar needs to be read in the second raka'ah as per that report. If you go with Suratul A'la, then Suratul Ghashiyah needs to be read in the second unit. But again, if you're not familiar with these chapters, you're free to read any portion from the Quran inshallah, and your salah will be valid. Once you're done with the recitation, you will go down for ruku', you will stand up, sami Allahu liman hamida, you will go down for sajda, the sitting in between the sajda, the last sajda, and then you will sit for tashahud, you will read your tashahud, and then as usual, you know, you can think of it like Salatul Jum'ah, like the Friday prayers, you will read your tashahud, and then you will give your taslim, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and with that, the prayer for Eid, Salatul Eid, comes to a beautiful end. Lastly, in regards to the khutbah, the sermon. Now, with Salatul Jum'ah, the Friday prayers, you have the sermon first and then the prayers. With Salatul Eid, the prayers come first and then you have the sermon. But bear in mind, the sermon is a sunnah action. You can choose to leave it and your prayer is still valid. I'm sure the scholars of the land that you come from, or the part of the world that you come from, will look at streaming their sermons, you know, the sermons that they do at home with their family members. So you can choose to tune in to one of these sermons and benefit from that scholar's reminder at that juncture in regards to the day of Eid, in regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in regards to the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. So you can choose to do that. And it does not have to be a live sermon that you're listening to. You can listen to a pre-recorded or the broadcast of a sermon that may have been, for example, if in your part of the world, Eid is on Saturday and then you're tuning into the sermon of a scholar who had celebrated his Eid on Friday, that is fine, that's completely fine. You can listen to a pre-recorded broadcast. It does not have to be a live session. I'd like to take this as an opportunity to wish and greet each and every one of you a very happy and blessed Eid from myself and the TDR team. It's early, I know, so it's an early wish, and I kind of want to be the first to greet you. So a very happy and blessed Eid. I wish you the very best, and I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses each and every one of us. And we also sincerely pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes this virus so that inshallah the upcoming Eid, Eid al-Adha, we celebrate it together.